Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the action here in Dublin. It's the Skybet World Grand Prix. Time to meet the players. Time to meet Flash Mark Dunbridge.
Semi-finalist last year, the fifth time he's reached the semi-finals here. So accurate on the doubles. The boos ring out around the City West Hotel for the pantomime villain of this great sport of darts we have. Your commentators, John Gwynne and Sid Waddell.
You're dead right. There's rumours that Simon Cowell's down here in his tightest T-shirt to check out the manly talent. Johnny, what do you reckon? Could be very tight and will be flavoursome.
Well, whatever happens, nobody will win by more than two sets, that for certain. That's the nature of this contest. In the first round, we've seen some real thrillers, one or two shocks along the way, and there you have. Lots of peat there is in Ireland, and there's plenty of it on that stage. There you see, double 20's favourite double, a semi-finalist, Sid, five times. Last year included.
Absolutely. Beaten at that stage by Terry Jenkins, 6-4. And here's the Grandmaster Flash, 8-4. In the Bristol area, actually placed by Bradley Stoke. Favorite double 20, but you can pick anyone you like to go off on. So here we go, and talking Premier Dart League, we're going to bigger and better venues, averaging 4,000, and Manly's in the frame strongly to be in that eight, Johnny.
Well, we all like the Amarillo march on, don't we, Sid? Even in the commentary box, we were dancing and jigging to it. It's infectious, just like this great game of darts. And there's a man, won the World Masters in 2002. Hadn't really heard a lot about the bridge before then, but made his name then, and he's certainly had his moment since. But this man, Peter Manley, very much a man on a mission. Premier League in mind.
Tried out a slow start in the Premier League. Manley, looking back at the stats, only got 3 180s in the first 4 weeks, but was the man who stole games. We've got some crappy draws. But his opponent has been Taylor. The Sierra round one in Las Vegas, 07. 6-5, that was the first time Dudders had been Taylor on telly. So the Taylor worries are coming in all over the place. There's Chrissy Manley, Peter's biggest fan. So I beat him in an exhibition the other week in Leeds. He won't let me tell him the punt is there.
Well, about a month ago, I did one with Peter in Manchester, perhaps a little longer. He had three bullseyes. He finished absolutely brilliantly all night, including standing on a chair from 12 feet away, hit double four. Now, if he can produce that on the telly, Sid, my.
Standing on a chair. I bet it was after 10 o'clock. Anyway, oh yes! Max on the flash.
Yes, and I don't think that 180 will be a flash in the pan. I think we might see one or two more, but Tonbridge 101 against the throw here, looking for an early lead.
Yeah, led up UK Open, nine dart attempt, lost to Andy Jenkins, just missed a double 12 for the nine darter. 49. And remember, second one of these at Rochester, Taylor Armstrong. Bull for a nine dotter. Somebody's bound to try and get very near. But key factor, John, in this is how worried this double start technique makes even the biggest and the best. Top's coming in for Dudders. On the wire, has to do a dipper, a slider needed. Lovely dot.
Yes, indeed, and beautifully executed, superbly described, said exactly as it happened. And Dudbridge takes the earliest of leads against the darts. He'd like to get the double again. The one he's just hit will do fine. He gets it underway. And good start this by Flash.
Here's the hammer. Well, earlier, we saw the carpet fitter pull the rug on Taylor. What we now have is Dudbridge is still doing up old houses and making them look good. Could certainly attack the foundations of the manly reputation here. Could be a belter. Beautiful on his day. Remember the world final, John, how he started against Taylor. Was brilliant in the first six sets of the power got at him.
Yeah, you're right. And if we remember those golden months for Dudbridge, 2004, he was a match play finalist at Blackpool. 7 months later, he was a world championship finalist, as you've just alluded to. And I actually believe, Sid, that at that time I believed that he was going to really, really hit the top, and he's never quite taken it on from there. But I think the evidence this year is that he might still be able to.
Yeah, best time right here was the quarterfinal 2005, and John's dead right. Loudmouth Geordie, I know, not sitting a million miles away from my shadow, is the guy who said this was world championship material, given that purple patch John has just so vividly described. He is not far away when he is missing here either. 60.
Unlucky there with his second dart. Oh, and 75. Even more so with the third.
Attention to detail, the key with darts, molybdenum, barrels, tungsten stuff, and the flights are tiny. See if you land them right, you can go past them. 60. All sorts of technology going on in the world of darts these days. Like people like Unicorn and Harrows.
Yes, and I'm told that Dudbridge still hasn't settled in his mind exactly the size and maybe even the shape of the flights that he needs. I don't think the colour matters too much. But
and while you see the things that Mervyn King throws, he's in with a good chance for this tournament. 65. The talented Mervyn King. His look like bamboo Malacca canes. Manly. Till level it up. One stops. Oh, no bother! Gotta watch him. He goes off his rock hard. I mean, goes madman.